alaikum wa rahmatullah. My dear sisters and my brothers, welcome to another under 9 minutes topic. Today I will talk about humans, our interaction with our children. When Allah introduced us to the angels in the early days before making Adam, Allah told the angel and he presented us with our function, not who we are, but rather what we are going to do. He told them, "Inni ja'ilun, I'm going to make on earth Khalifa." Khalifa is the one who leaves somebody behind them. Khalf is behind you, meaning each generation that is to come will, before leaving earth, leave another generation. And that's why humanity, we keep growing and we keep existing. It's because those that came before us made us and then they disappeared, and we also come, we make those behind us, and the wheel just keeps turning until Allah wraps up this world. As parents, we always have this tendency of wanting the best for our children. We always would love that our children keep listening to us as they did when they were little kids. And we, especially that we get used to the idea of bossing them around when they are young. And as they grow and they start formulating their own personality, they start discovering their own selves. And then we have the clash of the titans, parents versus kids. We live in a times where kids these days are more branched out, they are more plugged into another virtual world rather than being with the parents. And you see your kid at home with a phone in their hands. If you are doing whatever you're doing, look at your child, then 99% they are looking or doing something on their phone, and that creates some feeling of independence. We parents, we don't like that. And then the more the child approaches to puberty, the more the clash is stronger, especially when they get to the teenagerhood years, and that's where we suffer a lot. As a parent myself, I've tried a few things and I've prepared for these times way before they started. And I used to tell people in my preachings, all the talks and all the seminars and things like that, that instead for you to lament yourself and suffer when the calamity strikes, you better prepare for it. Just like a team of soccer or any other sport, they prepare for the competition before the competition takes place. Right. Now, a lot of parents don't do their homework and they wait until the competition comes in, and then they start panicking, and this is what creates the fire brigade approach or concept. The fire brigade concept is simple. A fire brigade will not leave the garage unless and until a fire has broken somewhere. Well, the same thing. A lot of people do not take any actions until the problem surfaces. They do not do the risk assessment, i.e. prevent the thing from happening. Now, here is one trick that I'm going to give you that will help you 100%. If you know how to apply it, it's a really simple trick, but it will help you gain back a good portion of the terrain with your kid. Here's the trick. Ask your child, if you don't want to ask them because the communication or conversation lines between you two are very wobbly and wiggly, well, do this. Try to find out what your child likes through other people. If they have siblings, do that. Ask the other brothers indirectly, of course. Don't be like kind of a spy. Just be tactful about that. If you don't have that, go to the school. Ask the teacher, ask the administration, demand or ask to speak to some of their friends, but do it in a very indirect way. The purpose of this exercise is to find out what your child likes. And I'm going to give two examples from my own personal experience, and then you can tailor the experience to your needs. Use the technique that I'm going to share with you. My youngest daughter, we have good relationship, alhamdulillah, better than her other brothers, because the other ones, brothers and sisters, have grown up. She's the youngest, alhamdulillah, everything is fine. But I am constantly, all the time, tweaking that relationship to get it to the best of what it can be. Sometimes she talks to me about a story about a dog. And then she asks me the genuine question, "Dad, why can't we have a dog?" Well, I always tell her, "Yeah, well, it's because of my schedule of work." And then what I do, I create an environment where she and I can talk about dogs without her being scared of me reprimanding her or just getting on her case. If your child, for example, you ask and you end up knowing that your kid likes some kind of cartoons, what you do is this. Watch a whole series, if you binge on a series of that cartoon, get to know the characters of that cartoon or movie or soccer game or anything that your child is interested in. 95% these days is gotta do something with YouTube and the trends and things like that. Get knowledgeable about these trends. Then what you do is simple. One day, look for a time when the relationship, well, things are really calm between you and the child. The child is not angry, something has happened, there is a good vibe going on there, and then drop like atomic bomb on them. Ask them. Oh, by the way, and I go back to my daughter. She likes the golden retriever, and she likes the white one, and that's what I found out. So from time to time, when everything is fun, and I tell her, oh my God, there is this, and it's true, I've seen this on YouTube, this golden retriever, the white, and he's doing this, and her eyes light up. And then we go on YouTube, and we spend a good hour. It's an investment from my part about that. And then suddenly we've got something to talk about that moment. And then later on, when things are not going well, what I do, I just bring the white Labrador or the white golden retriever into the action. And that's it. Boom. That good link is established with my young man, my son, who is 28 years of age, very independent, very professional, all that kind of stuff. Communication is scarce these days because it's just the difference of level of dad and son. So what I did, I found out what kind of movies he likes. And then once I found out what kind of movies he liked, we started talking about them. I sent him a text on WhatsApp. Oh, John Wick 3 has come out. Did you see it? No, I would love to see it. And then last night I downloaded the movie, purchased it, and then I invited him to come. And I did this few times with him. And now he loves coming home because he knows when he comes home, he's going to come home to a dad who is at the same level. We've got suddenly a few things to talk because from John Wick and other movies, we branched out to other things. And I know those topics that cause him not to want to talk about certain things, so I block them. Now, when we watch movies and we do things together, he goes home and sends me a message saying I had good time. Last night, he surprised me. Because usually I tell him, come and visit and things like that. Last night, he just rang me out of the blue. And he said, Dad, you're home? I said, yeah. He goes, can I come? I said, of course you can come. And then when he came, we ordered some food. And we watched another movie. And we had a good laugh. And he went home. So now, you see, and always, 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 when you leave your child, always leave them on a high note, a positive note. Don't yell at your child and end the conversation there. Always finish off on a high note and pick up from that high note the next time you talk to them. Watch how this trick will work for you. I pray to Allah that this will serve you well as it did serve me and still does serve me well. And until my next under 9 minutes, please stay in the mercy of Allah. Avoid major sins, repent from the small ones, keep your salat on time, and I'll speak to you pretty soon, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.